Hello everyone, today we have new video review, and as you can see, this time we are going to check fresh release from Miniart. It is molded in 135 scale, even though it copies Cierva C.30 with winter ski, so it's an aircraft, but still it is molded in 135 scale, which might look unusual to you, but for me it is fine because it's a Miniart kit. This is a commercial sample, so it means you will get exactly the same stuff as what you will see in this video review. We are going to open it and check what is hidden inside. So, first of all, here it's written that we have decals for 4 marking options, PE included. We will see it further in the review. Here you can see comparison with my hand. It's a standard Miniart box. And then on the side we have some safety information, address of the manufacturer in case you would like to visit them. And here you can see also 4 marking options which are included here. So 2 blue and 2 gray, or white as you prefer, but they look quite interesting and there is definitely something to copy. So let's open it. It's a top opening box, so just give me a second. It's a tight fit, so I will have to do it off the camera. I'm not sure why it is so tight. So, moment. Okay, now it's open. Here it is. So, what do we have inside? As usual, all frames are packed into the same plastic bag, and also assembly manual is placed on the bottom of the box. We will check first the plastic parts, obviously, and then we will start with... Actually, continue with assembly manual. Now I am opening the plastic bag, because as usual it is sealed plastic bag, so if you plan to check all the sprues in the model shop, you won't be able to do it, and it's not because the seller is being the... you know what I mean? It's because all frames are sealed in one plastic bag, and you have nothing to do with it. I mean, you can't open it, because otherwise your seller will be really pissed off. Anyway, here we have the first thing which is included into this kit. This is a small envelope with Miniart logo, so let's open it. And here we have small PE thread for fine external and internal detailing. So these are unpainted PE parts, and even though here we have seat belts, they are still unpainted, so you can use them and paint them in whatever color you would prefer to. That's really nice. Some modelers are really happy to see such bonus. I'm completely fine, because I mean, this is still PE thread, not that many brands give it out of the box, so bonus point for this definitely. Okay, so next plastic bag is being opened and we will check what is there. So first of all, here we have the clear plastic frame. As you can see, only 2 windshields are placed here. Masks are not included, so if you would like to cover them, you have to cut the masks with your own hands or your own tools. Next we have this decals sheet. So as you can see, it is printed in decograph. There should be a sign here. Now we also have separate dials for the instrument panel, and all the symbols look quite nice. I don't have anything to complain about. Maybe we can close the camera so that you can see that this is a quite dark decals sheet. I mean, I'm not sure why camera makes it so bright, but it was in the right colors. Okay, now we start with gray plastic frames. So first one is dedicated to the various struts which will be holding the top section with propeller, and also here we have the cockpit wall, actually thin frame with which you have to be extra careful in order to not to damage. And of course the tail wheel leg. I'm not sure if the winter variant actually carries it, but I mean, it is included here, and we will have to consult with assembly manual in order to understand if it is like this. Next, we go on with new plastic frame. This one carries skis. Also here we have engine parts, cooling parts. Note that each exhaust will have to be attached separately, and here we have propeller with attachment points right on the blades. Not that cool, but I mean, with some due care you will be able to let's say separate this part and get it ready to be installed on the model. Next, these sprues are absolutely identical, and these are large blades. As you can see, they are supplied in this state. They are slightly bent as far as you can see, so they will replicate this natural bend of the blades which is present on the real helicopters. And of course here you have to combine it with these minor beads. I'm not sure how those large blades will hold in place just on the small circle, so maybe later we'll try to do the test build, because it's really interesting for me how all this stuff will stay in place. Next, we have here the more of the cockpit parts and also some of the external parts as well. Here you can see two pilot seats, that's a fairing for the top section, various handles are here. That's really cool that pilot seats are one-piece elements. Here you can see them from another side. And all in all, everything looks fine. The only thing you can see here, actually those are two separate parts, right? So, I hope so. Next, we go on with first sprue with fuselage parts. So here you can see left fuselage half. It is molded together with tail section. We have quite nice replication of the fabric surface. Here you can see it closer and definitely deserves some nice pre-shading done on this surface in order to bring out those features. Also, we have a lot of thin parts. Again, we have here the cockpit frame, and if we flip over here inside, you can see that we have minor detailing in the cockpit area, because it will be visible. We have open cockpit here no matter what, so it will be exposed to the viewer. So keep it in mind, maybe it's worth investing some time into some weathering ideas, maybe with some, let's say, painting techniques employed, you will get a different result. Another plastic sprue here, we have another propeller type, I guess this one won't be used, the same applies to this engine parts, except of these two. Also fuselage half, right one, and again the same level of detailing. That's really cool, I mean I like how it looks, and I think in the finished state it should look really impressive. And I guess the same goes on here, so we have quite nice detailing inside. Also here we have instrument panels. Let's zoom in. So they feature pre-molded dials. You will have to place there the dial decals which were included into this kit. So basically out of the box you can get a really nice cockpit without any extra money spent. So again, bonus point for this. I mean, P is the thing which will ensure such result. Next we go on with assembly manual. So assembly manual was on the bottom of the box. Here it is. Let's zoom out a bit and close the lenses. So now you should be able to see it. Here we have quite interesting feature, because here we have the winter variant and here we have the wheeled aircraft. Well, maybe they forgot to change it. Nevertheless, here you can see short list of the features. Next, we go on with first marking option. This one comes from Sweden, late 1930s. Next one is a parts map. Assembly process starts with engine, then we continue with cockpit, and straight away you will have to use P parts. You also have to use them here, as far as I remember, because all those ends for the exhaust, they will have to be accompanied with P parts. That might be a bit tedious work to do. Next we go on with these cockpit frames, and note that all levers will be replicated with the P parts here as well. Here you can see the instrument panel being installed, and we continue with cockpit four. So basically this part had to be a one piece. I'm not sure why it was separated in my kit, but it's just a matter of gluing them together. Next we continue with side walls for the cockpit. The same goes on here with fuselage, so you can position the door in open or closed position in order to expose more of the cockpit, obviously. Next, we continue by installing the cockpit between fuselage halves. Here we start assembling the top section of the aircraft. Here we have the top cooling panel, side panel as well. Next, we continue with tail ending gear. As you can see, it will have to be combined with ski, which is really cool, in my opinion. Next, we have the tail surfaces. All this stuff will be attached here. Next, we continue with those special struts which we assembled before. Those are special struts for the landing gear. They will be protruding from the fuselage just like this. It will be quite an interesting, unusual, let's say, looking aircraft. Here we have the propeller attachment process. Next we have quite a nice feature, because you can assemble the flying position and you can assemble the transport position. And this transport position, all blades will be folded together, and it might be a good option for those who think that such way, such style will make it easier to transport the model on various exhibitions. Here we have another marking option. This one comes from Swedish Navy Service, early 1940s. And next we have two white aircraft. This one comes from late 1940s and another one late 1940s as well. All aircraft come from Sweden. And this is quite interesting paint shade. I'm not lazy, I'll check what is this color, because it was 02, so it's, nope, 07. Yeah, 07. So it should be pure white, which is really cool. You might replicate it with this kit. So as I said, this kit is already available for purchase. You can get it in Modelimax webshop. Of course, I will be happy to hear your opinion about this kit here in the comment section below. If you like this video, don't forget to press the like button and also subscribe. And I will see you in the next video review as usual. Thank you for joining me today, and bye.